To provide unemployment to people during the pandemic period, the Odisha government has launched a new scheme for promoting intensive aquaculture through biofloc technology in fisheries, as per Minister Arun Sahu. He said that the scheme will provide livelihood support to entrepreneurs, unemployed youth and interested progressive fish farmers, and will also increase fish production in the state. He said that the scheme is most suitable for youths who face unemployment during the pandemic. To give you a brief about biofloc, is biofloc farming is actually based on a new technology that thinks about intensive fish or shrimp production in a limited area without significantly increasing the usage of the basic natural resources of water and land. A person having small land holding as small as 150 to 200 square meters of land and having either municipal piped water supply or borewell water supply can establish this business with a small investment. This program aims to support fish farmers and young entrepreneurs for generation of income and livelihood support. So biofloc system is suitable for growing freshwater fish species such as GIFT, tilapia, magur, pangasius, arnabas, common carp and others depending on local market demands. In this context, we spoke to Dr. Sarkar, who is working with the Central Institute of Fisheries and Aquaculture, and he spoke to us about the details of biofloc farming, how feasible it is for fish farmers to start, how feasible it will be for the youths to start, and how what would be the productivity in case somebody invests a particular amount of time. This is what he said about biofloc farming.
Biofloc technology in fisheries, which Minister Arun Sahu had announced yesterday, it's going to provide livelihood support to entrepreneurs, unemployed youth, and progressive fish farmers. So I just wanted to know an expert opinion from you, since you are specializing in this.
First of all, this is a technology. First, why we will do this biofloc? Okay, that is we need to understand.
Yes,
this is a technology where you can produce significantly higher amount of fish from a small volume of water as compared to the traditional pond-based aquaculture.
Okay.
This is
okay.
the main purpose.
Okay. Yeah.
And other advantages are like it is a biosecure system.
Mm-hmm.
Means everything is under your control.
Mm-hmm.
You can grow it in a confined environment. So some of the parameters, environmental parameters, you can control within that confined environment.
So
another advantage is that here any fish behavior or anything you can monitor, because fish are in the tank, so any abnormalities you can monitor very easily, and you can take the corrective measures immediately.
Okay.
So these are the advantage. Another advantage, you know that today water is a very scarce resource.
Correct.
Going to be very shortage in future.
Yes.
So this is a water saving technology. Means since you are producing lot of fish from a little volume of water, so you are actually saving water. So these are the advantage.
Okay.
Now the technical technological aspect, I will say little bit about this.
Yeah.
See, whenever we are growing fish, we are adding actually feed, commercial feed to boost its production, right? To get quick growth and all these things. So in this case, fish release a lot of excreta.
Right.
Both in terms of solid as well as ionic form. Like I'm giving an example. When you give fish a protein feed, mostly feed are given for protein source. Okay, protein and of course other source, but protein is a major component. So during this metabolism, fish release ammonia. Okay, so this ammonia remain in the water. Now, if you grow high amount of fish from a small volume of water, then definitely you are adding too much of feed in a little volume of water.
Yes.
So this ammonia will get accumulated.
Okay. Yeah.
Another thing is that fish after digestion, fish releases excreta.
Okay.
So that excreta will also get accumulated in the water body.
Right.
So this actually a problem for fish because it creates undesirable condition, water quality conditions that actually hinder the fish growth.
Okay,
you can't grow like this. Okay. So we have to create some conditions so that these metabolites or the toxic chemicals or whatever, this thing has to be alleviated. It has to be reduced or so that water remain in a good condition.
Investment involved in the technology to start Bioflow.
There is two aspects. One is your capital expenditure and another thing is your operational expenditure.
Correct. Yes.
Now capital expenditure may be same for all fish species.
Okay.
But that operational expenditure depends on the type of species that you are growing.
Okay.
Like I'm giving you an example. Whatever is available today is that that tarpaulin plastic made tank.
Okay.
In the market, which is which contain around 10,000 liter of water.
Yes.
Of course, you can increase the water volume by increasing the size of the tank.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. So, say for example, this 10,000 liter tank, it will cost around, of course it depends, but it depends, whatever present things available in the market, it will cost around 15,000 to 20,000. The variation is due to availability of material in your local area.
Okay.
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 So, 15,000 to 20,000 for per tank.
Okay.
Now, you have to arrange aeration system, means oxygenation.
Okay.
Okay. So for say for I am giving you a it is a four tank model. So though there is no actually such type of models available, but farmers are doing at their own level testing different things. So for four models, maybe you need four means 40,000 liter water. You may need at least 1 HP air blower, which will be costing around say 20,000.
Okay.
And then of course their arrangement means some pipe pipe arrangement and aeration air stones, all these things will be there. So around 25,000. So tank is around say 60,000, and then your aeration system is around 20,000. So total 80,000. Then that of course some shedding must be there. Shedding means that green shade net.
Yes.
You can arrange. So that is that depends up to local availability. People are using bamboo, locally available bamboo for these things. So it will cost maybe around 20,000. Of course, that depends. So this is maybe say for 1 to 1.2 lakh. You can consider for capital expenditure.
Okay.
Now the cost of seed and other thing. In a nutshell, I will tell you that the operational cost for fish production, say for pangas or tilapia or other fish, it will be per kilo production. It will be around 70 to 80 rupees. So this is a big concern because the price of production is high in this case.
Okay.
This is operational expenditure I'm talking about.
Yes.
Cost of production for fish, excluding the capital expenditure.
Okay.
Now it depends upon your local price of that particular fish. Say for example, if you grow pangas fish in Orissa, there will be, in my opinion, I don't know the exact situation, in my opinion, pangas price is very less in Orissa market.
Okay.
But on the contradictory is that if you go to northern part of India, like Punjab, Haryana, or those portion, Delhi, UP, there the pangas price is almost at par with Rohu Katla.
Okay.
So, there it will be a profitable, but I doubt how much it will be profitable if you market the same fish is here in Orissa. This is a big concern, I think.
Okay, thank you. Thank you so much, Dr. Sarkar, for speaking to us.
Okay, thank you very much.